Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. I could not resist. I have enough cameras to go around for a few years, but there's just something about a super zoom that I can't resist. And Canon's new SX50, I had to buy it. I went and did it. And I was going to even do a box opening thing. You know how they have the videos for like, I'm opening the box. I'm up. No, forget it. I opened it. You missed the whole thing. So anyway, I bought it. I can't believe I bought this camera. But I just love the super zoom cameras. And this one is, I have never seen a super zoom camera like this before. It goes from 24. Yeah, it's not 28. And this is just a little $400 camera, $450. I think I paid $399. And it goes from 24 millimeters, not to 400, not to 600. It doesn't go from 24 to 700. It doesn't go from 24 to 750. It doesn't go from 24 to 800. Aha, you thought I was going to stop at 800. It goes from 24 to 1200 millimeters. Do you know how big a 1200 millimeter zoom, not a zoom, a 1200 millimeter telephoto lens? It'd be bigger than I could put in this frame. That's how big they would be. And that's what's in this little camera. And it's not only a powerful a zoom on here, but it's a good zoom, meaning it just good quality. So I had to pick it up. So I figured I'd share it with you. So what's this camera good for? This camera is probably one of the best all-around family cameras you can get. It's got a zoom from 24 to 1200, 1200. So if you took the kids to the zoo, you can make it look like you were over there petting the lion or something. It's just amazing. It does 1080p on the video. It does RAW. I have a RAW workflow. So that means that I don't like to shoot and have the picture come out as a JPEG. I like it to come out as a RAW file. And then it goes into the computer. I do quick touch-ups, correct the exposure, correct the color balance, and boom. I export them into JPEGs. And not only that, I export them into JPEGs of two sizes, the full resolution of the camera, and also a little one to go online. All right. Now, this is, I wish they had given me the specs. I should have read them before I came on here. They didn't pack it with megapixels. I believe it's 12. Yeah, 12 megapixels. So it's got plenty of megapixels to make 20 by 30s. It does RAW. It's got a hot shoe. Did I mention it has a 24 millimeter to 1200 millimeter zoom? That just flabbergasts me. I can't believe it. And the camera is small. It really is. It's not a big camera. It's very small. And with a 24 millimeter, that means I can actually take videos of myself by turning the camera around, and the LCD articulates. It goes back and forth. So you can see all my lights. See my lights? And I can close it, and it gives me a hard back so it doesn't get scratched. It's just a very impressive camera, so I had to share it with you. I don't have much to say about it because I shouldn't have bought another camera, you know, because I've got the little Sony, the RX100, which is wonderful. It goes in the pocket. This one's not going to go in your pocket, but it'll go into some kind of a bag, or if you put the strap or the hand strap on here. But it gives you a 1200 millimeter zoom, stabilized. It's stabilized zoom, raw, 24 millimeters on the bottom end, has a hot shoe, does 1080p video, meaning great for the kids, great for everything. So if you're looking for an all-around camera and you want an all-in-one thing, meaning everything that you can get shoved down into one camera, you don't want to spend $1,200 because you don't want to get into the Micro Four Thirds or one of these new systems, but you want a darn good little super zoom, and you want to be able to extract the best quality out of it. I got to get a tooth extractor with the RAW, and Lightroom already is taking this RAW, so you don't have to wait. So I bought it. I figured I'd share it with you. I can recommend it. Instead of a DSLR for a lot of you guys, buy one of these. Even if you're a YouTuber, okay, and you want to, you know, you put this on the, whatchamacallit, the tripod, and just take pictures, take videos. It works. So that's why I bought it. And you know, I had the original SX1S. Then I bought the SX3S. I still have that one, I think. And then the SX5S. It's actually SX5IS, SX3IS. Okay. So this is the SX50IS. So I'm familiar with the camera. So I give this one a huge thumbs up. It's just got everything in here. The only thing that you don't have is you don't have a lot of the controls that you have on a DSLR, the big ones where you can change the lenses. But for a camera for your family, to have it in your car with you, it's got a proprietary battery, but it's lithium ion. It uses an SD card. I already mentioned it does 1080p video. So you can take videos, put them on your TV of your pets or your family or Aunt Agnes or whatever it is you want to put up there. And it's just an amazing buy. Now, what makes it amazing is there's other cameras that have similar. There's none on the market right now that you can get with that wide of a 24mm to 1200. But there's some coming. I've seen the announcements. But I don't know if they're going to have RAW. And I don't know what the quality is going to be. One of the reasons that I like this camera is, of course, I do a lot of research. I like the quality. What good is it to have a quality? I mean, to have a camera that's got everything in it and gives you crappy pictures. I mean, give me a break. You want to be able to... what if you took something that really deserves to become wall art, to make a big picture and hang it on the wall? Okay, this has the ability to have that quality level built into it. So that's why I'm recommending it with three thumbs up. I know you can't go beyond one or two thumbs up, but, you know, figure out where you get your third thumb and stick it up there. So, oh, that was nasty. No, don't write anything nasty down below, okay, because this is a family show. All right, but anyway, it's got built-in flash. It's got a hot shoe flash. It's got RAW. The lens is stabilized. 24, which is wider than all your basic standard point and shoots, which usually are 28 millimeters, and they stop at maybe 1, 110, 130, or if they go a little wider, it might be 24 to 100, all right? This goes from 24 to 1200, so they did a great job on this camera. That's why I had to buy it. I'm almost offering apologies to you guys because it's like, why is Peter buying so many cameras? A lot of cameras I get, they come in for me to do a review, and they go back. So don't think I've got a shelf full of cameras. Well, I kind of do, but a lot of them are old film cameras, all right? But my digital cameras for my business, product shots, the high school seniors, which I do a lot of, and then weddings, I've got my Nikons, Canons, and stuff like that. And then I got my little pocket camera, the RX100 from Sony, which is the best pocket camera you can buy. Single pocket. It's the best pocket camera you can buy in terms of picture quality because it's got a bigger sensor than all the rest of them, bigger than this one too. But Canon did a great job on this. They didn't cram it full of pixels so that your images are not so clean. They kept a level head and put an amazing lens on this, stabilized everything in one. I'm rambling now. I'm just going on and on and on. I'm not trying to convince myself. Well, maybe I am because I shouldn't have bought it, but I got to have it and it's mine. Okay, this is mine. You go get your own. All right. Anything you have or any comments that you have on this camera, write them down below me in the writing section and the comment section, actually, and I'll read them sometimes. All right. Peter Gregg from Miami, Florida. Huge thumbs up for the Canon SX50. Yeah, go buy it. You won't be disappointed. All right. Bye-bye. Bye. Go away. Bye. Bye means go buy the camera. That's right. All right. Later.